So let us start our discussion. In today's class, we are going to discuss about multi-level clippers where you could see more than two diodes. Okay. So far in our earlier class, we have discussed about two-level clippers where you could see a maximum of two diodes only. But here you could see more than two diodes. Okay. That can be extended even up to four diodes also. But nevertheless, let us first start with circuit which is having three diodes. Okay, so the question is like this: you are asked to plot the transfer characteristics, that is plot between input voltage and the output voltage, and you need to vary your input voltage from 0 volts to 50 volts. Okay, so that is what is the question. When you are varying your input from 0 volts to 50 volts, plot the transfer characteristics. Okay, right. So I'll be starting like this. Okay, so let me start with, let my Vi is equal to 0. Okay, let my Vi is equal to 0. From where to where I need to vary my input signal is from 0 to 50 volts I need to vary. So let us say what happens when my Vi is 0. So when my Vi is 0, right, what do you say about the state of the diodes D3, D1, D2? What do you say about state of the diodes D3? D1, D2, state of the diodes D3, is D3 is going to be on or off? D3, whose positive is tied to the input signal, and you are saying that your input signal is 0, okay? And to the N side of the D3, it is connected through some diodes, okay? At least some 20 volts, right? So what do you say about D3? D3 is off. Off. Very good. So D3 is off. What do you say about D1? As my positive of my D1 is connected to 6 volts, and negative has been on. D1 is on. And D2 is
off.
Off. Because my N side of my D2 is connected to 20 volts, and I am saying that my Vi is 0, so definitely D2 is going to be off. With the D3 on, D1 on, D2 off. See, actually, if there are three diodes, how many states are going to exist? Eight states, okay? So, but handling those eight states is not an easy thing. So, that is why we will be going in a straightforward way with which we will be getting our answer of plotting the transfer characteristics. Okay? So, I will be starting with Vi is equal to 0, where I could say that my D3 is off, D1 is on, and D2 is off. Okay, right. So with the D3 off, D1 on, and D2 off, can I draw my equivalent circuit? Yes, I can. Okay, so I'll be drawing my equivalent circuit corresponding to D3 off, D1 on, and D2 off. So D1 is off, 2.5 kilo ohms. Okay, 2.5 kilo ohms is 5k. So what is my output is being given by? My output is being given by anyone. What is my output is being given by? So can I consider this particular branch or not? 2.5 kilo ohms branch, shall I consider this or not?
No.
No, because this is open circuit. Okay, so this is nowhere related to your input. So no need of considering this. This particular branch is also removed because of open circuit. So only thing is this branch, okay, which you could see your 5 kilo ohm followed by your 6 volts, and there is a 1 kilo ohm, 1 5 kilo ohm resistor across which you are finding your output voltage. Okay, so it is like voltage across your 5 kilo ohm resistor or in between this 5 kilo ohm plus 6 volts. Okay. So you can try to find the current that is flowing through this closed loop, okay? Then you can find out the drop across 5 kilo ohm plus 6 volts, okay? And if at all current is flowing in this particular loop, in which direction it is flowing? The diode that is on in this particular situation is only D1, and that too it has to flow from P side to the N side, okay? P side to the N side, right? So my current that is flowing in accordance with the diode current that is D1, that is from P side to the N side. So you need to find out this current I, Okay, yes, I can find out by applying the KVL. What is my KVL is minus 6 volts plus 5i, so that I will be in the milliamperes, plus 5i is equal to 0. Is this fine? My I is given by minus 6 plus 5i plus 5i is equal to 0. So this middle branch is not there because open circuit. Okay, so this middle branch is not there. This middle branch is not there because open circuit. So current is flowing in this direction according to your current direction of your diode D1. So my I is given by minus 6 plus 5i plus 5i is equal to 0. So what is my I is given by? So that my output voltage is given by
6 by 10.
6 by 10. That is how much? 0.6 milliamperes. The current whatever we are trying to find out is in milliamperes. So I is equal to 0.6 milliamperes. If I is 0.6 milliamperes, what is my voltage is given by? My voltage is nothing but drop across 5 kilo ohms. Okay. My V naught is given by drop across 5 kilo ohms. Okay. So what is my drop across 5 kilo ohms? 0.6 into 5. 0.6 is milliamperes, 5 is kilo, right? Both cancelled. So my output voltage is 3 volts. Okay. My output voltage is 3 volts. Right. So understand carefully, okay? So I have considered my Vi is equal to 0. With Vi is equal to 0, D3 is off, D1 is on, D2 is off. Okay? Right? So with these three assumptions, right, we tried to find out the voltage. Then we got that my voltage as 3 volts. Okay? Right? So whatever the voltage that we got here is here, 3 volts. The same is the voltage even here also. Right? Is that not the same voltage is going to be appearing at N side of your D1? Please do understand, okay? N side of your D1, okay, which is tied to your 3 volts. So now you tell me how long your D3 is going to be in the off state. If the P side, if the N side of my D1 is tied to 3 volts, how long your D3 is going to be in the off state? For my D3 to be in the off state, my P side of my D3 has to be less than my N side. As N side you found out to be 3 volts, until your input is up to 3 volts, your diode D3 will be in the off state. Okay. So not only Vi is equal to 0, even if you increase your input voltage up to 3 volts, okay, until less than or equal to 3 volts your input, your D3 is still going to be in the off state, D1 will be in the on state, D2 will be in the off state, so that your output, which is 3 volts, is going to be holding good. Okay, your output 3 volts is valid until your Vi is less than or equal to 3 volts. Why it is valid only up to less than or equal to 3 volts? Because when once your Vi is greater than 3 volts, your P side of the D3 is greater than the N side of the D3, which is 3 volts, then your D3 is no more in the off state, then whatever the voltage you got is no more valid. Okay, so my first interval is right from 0 to 3 volts, my output is going to be 3 volts. Okay, so what is my conclusion now? My conclusion now is for my first interval, that is 0 to 3 volts, okay, less than 3 volts, right, or equal to 3 volts, my D3 is off, D1 is on, D2 is off, with which I got my output as 3 volts. Okay, so as my input is being varied from 0 to 50 volts, now I am able to vary up to 3 volts. So up to 3 volts, my output is 3 volts. Up to my variation of my 3 volts, my output is 3 volts. Okay, right? Okay. So now let me vary my input voltage from 3 to, okay, what should be the next value that I can choose based on the given circuit? Anyone?
6.
6, very good. 6. Okay. So I'll be assuming that, okay, let us vary my input. More than 3 and less than 6. So with my input more than 3, what is my immediate observation? D3 is
on.
D3 is on. Okay. D1 is. Okay. As positive of the D1 is tied to the 6 volts, as my input is less than 6 volts, what do you say about the D1?
Off.
On.
On. On. Okay. My N side of my D1 is less than my P side of the D1, is it not? My Vi is less than 6. As 6 is tied to your p side, if my vi is less than 6, is it not that my n side is less than my p side? Then it is in the on state. So d1 is still be in the on state. What do you say about d2? D2 is off. Okay. Why? Because you have ended up your input much less than 6 volts only. And to the n side of your d2, you have connected 20 volts. Until and otherwise, your input is at least greater than 20, you may not expect your d2 to be in the on state. So your d2 is off, d1 is on, and d3 is on. With d3 on, d1 on, and d2 off, you can draw the equivalent circuit. Why? What for we are drawing the equivalent circuit? For finding out the output voltage. Our primary task here is, for certain range of input signal, we need to find the output voltage, that's all. Until a range of input signal 0 to 3, we got the output voltage. Now we are selecting another range of input signal, that is from 3 to 6. Okay? So let us draw the equivalent circuit within the interval 3 to 6. So what is my equivalent circuit? How does it is going to look like? My D3 is on, so short circuit. Okay? My equivalent circuit is okay for you? Equivalent circuit, how I have drawn? When once you know what are the states of your diodes, drawing the equivalent circuit not a big thing. Okay? So you replace your D3 with on, D1 with on, and D2 with off. So that is why there is no branch related to your D2. Okay? Can you find out your output now? Now, your output is dependent on two things. One is on your input, one is on your 6 volts DC. Is it not? Can you apply your superposition principle? You can find your output within this range. Okay. This time your output is due to two things. One is VI as well as your 6 volts battery. Okay. When you are finding your output due to the 6 volts battery, you make your VI 0. Okay. Then find out your output. When you are finding your output due to the VI, you make your 6 volts 0. Then find out the output. Then your overall output is being given by the sum of the individual outputs due to the 6 volts as well as due to the input voltage VI. Okay. So can you do it for me? What is my output is being given by? Please do it yourself. Okay. I am not going to do. Please, you have to do it. Please do it and tell me what is your output. You need to find your output applying the superposition principle. As there are two sources, one is input, another is 6 volts. You need to find the output individually. While finding the output due to the 6 volts battery, make your input VI short circuited. Okay, making VI 0 means making it short circuited. Replace VI with short circuit. Then find out the output. While finding the output due to the VI, make the 6 volts 0. Right? Then find out the output due to the VI. Then the overall output is sum of both the individual responses. Okay, so tell me what is output V0 is. So V0 is equal to, let us say V0 dash plus V0 double dash. V0 dash is due to 6 volts and V0 double dash is due to VI. Okay, so tell me what is V0 dash and V0 double dash. V0 dash means due to the 6 volts, so that means you have to make your VI 0. Make your VI 0. Then what is my output is given by?
1.5 volts.
V0 dash, yeah?
Yes, sir.
Okay, 1.5 volts. Then what is V0 double dash? V0 double dash means you need to replace your 6 volts short circuited. And you need to represent your VI here. So my VI is here. So find out your output due to the VI now. So I think it is quite simple. 5 kilo ohm and 5 kilo ohm are in parallel. So this is nothing but equivalent resistance, which is 2.5. Voltage across 5 kilo ohm or voltage across 5 kilo ohm, both are same. Okay, so the equivalent resistance is 2.5K. And when VI is here, 2.5K and 2.5K, so equally divided. So V0 double dash is equal to VI by 2. Okay. I think it is easy. Straightforward. 5 kilo ohm and 5 kilo ohm are in parallel. So equivalent resistance is 2.5K. And as 2.5K and 2.5K are in series, voltage division rule, V0 is equal to VI by 2. Is this okay? Yes or no? Okay, so what is my output is given by within this range? My output is given by Vi by 2 plus 1.5. Okay, when V naught is equal to 6 volts, what is your Vi is equal to? I hope you are able to understand why I am finding my input voltage for my V naught is equal to 6 volts. Okay, as long as your Vi is less than 6, okay. As long as your Vi is less than 6, your D1 is guaranteed to be in the off on state. Yes or no? So far now, D1 is in the on state because your Vi is less than 6. Okay? So, that means the output, whatever we are able to get here, which is the N side of my D1, okay, it can go up to 6 volts. Okay? For my output to be 6 volts, what can be the maximum input that I can have here? That is what I am interested in. Okay, so that I can vary my input up to that value so that my output can go up to a maximum of 6, which will be ensuring that my D1 is in the on state. Okay, until my node voltage here is greater than 6, because my P side is tied to the 6, my D1 will never be in the off state. Okay, until this voltage is greater than 6, then only D1 is going to be in the off state, otherwise it will be in the on state only. So this, let this particular node voltage be 6. That is nothing but your output voltage is being 6. For your output voltage being 6, what is your Vi is? For output voltage, for output voltage is 6 volts, Vi is 9. Okay. So that means what? Initially we thought that for input in between 3 to 6, my D1 is said to be in the off state. But upon finding the relationship between the V0 and the Vi, we have come to know that we know that this D1 can still be in the off state as long as this particular node voltage is less than or equal to 6, because P side it ties to the 6. And as this is my output voltage in between this particular range, for my output to go to the maximum of 6 volts, what should be my input? My input is 9 volts. So that means not only up to 6 volts, I can go up to my 9 volts, okay, so that my D1 is still be in the on state. Okay, my D1 will still be in the on state, because even when my input is 9 volts, my output is going to be 6 volts, which will ensure that my D1 is still in the on state. Okay, right. So instead of 3 to 6, now I'll say that my output input range is 3 to 9. Right. So whatever we have found out, this is valid not only up to 6, but even up to 9. Okay, right. So initially we started with 0 to 3. Okay, then we started with 3 to 6, and we have come to know that up to what value of input that I can vary, okay, so that my D1 can still be in the on state. Fine? Okay. So now what is the next interval that I can vary? Next interval is 9 to, okay, 9 to. What is the next interval? 9 to. 9 to. What is the upper limit?
20.
Okay, so within this 9 to 20, what are the states of my diodes? Within this 9 to 20, what are my states of the diodes? D3 is on. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, D1 is
off.
Off. D2 is Vi on. Is less than 20. D2 is off. With the D3 on, D1 off, D2 off, what is my equivalent circuit is going to look like? My equivalent circuit is going to look like this. Yes or no? This is 2.5K. D1 is removed, D2 is removed. Okay. So then I am having this 5K. This is my input and this is my output. Okay. Can you find out your output now? Can you find out your output now? Can you find out your output now? Within this interval, 9 to 20. Output is given by input into 5 kilo ohm by 5 kilo ohm plus 2.5 kilo ohm. So what is your output is given by?
2Vi by 3.
2Vi by? Okay, so now what is that I have to find out? I have to make sure that how long my D2 is going to be in the off state. How long your D2 is going to be in the off state? As long as this particular node voltage, which is nothing but your output, is less than or equal to 20, okay, then your D2 is going to be in the off state. When once your output is greater than 20, then your P side of D2 is greater than 20, which is nothing but your N side, then your D2 will be in the on state, okay. So for your output to be up to a maximum of 20, what should be the input voltage? For my output to be 20 volts, what should be my input voltage?
30 volts.
For output is equal to 20 volts, what should be my input voltage? 30 volts. Okay. So that means what? I can go even beyond this 20 up to 30. Okay. My input can be varied right from 9 to not only 20, but even I can go up to 30. So that still my output can go up to 20 only, so that still my D2 can be in the off state only. Until and otherwise, this particular node voltage is greater than 20, this D2 will never come into the on state. So for this particular node voltage, which is nothing but my output to be a maximum of 20, what is my input voltage? That is 30. So I can go up to 30 volts instead of 20. Okay, so my output voltage is, okay, my output voltage is given by 2/3 VI for my input range of 9 to 30. Okay, for my input range of 9 to 30. Okay, right? Okay. Please do remember, okay, over the interval 0 to 3, output is given by 3 volts. Okay, over the interval 3 to 9, my output is given by VI by 2 plus 1.5. Okay, 9 to 30, what is my output is given by?
20 volts.
20 volts, okay. Now, what is that I can have my input range? 32. What is the range of input signal that is given in the question?
50.
50, 0 to 50. Right. So, for VI greater than 30 and less than 50, okay. What is the state of my diodes? D3 is? On.
On.
D1 is?
Off.
Off. D2 is?
On.
On. So let me draw the equivalent circuit. So D3 is on. D1 is off. D2 is on. So this is my 5k, this is 10k, this is 20, this is 2.5k, this is my input, okay. So can you find out your output? This time my output is dependent on two things. One is due to the input VI and due to the 20 volts. Just like how you have found out your output earlier due to two sources, here also your output is due to the input source as well as due to the 20 volt source. Okay, so tell me quickly what is your output is. I will be writing here my output as V naught dash plus V naught double dash. Let V naught dash be due to VI and V naught double dash be due to 20 volts. So tell me what is V naught dash and V naught double dash. V naught dash is due to VI, V naught double dash is due to 20 volts. Okay, V naught dash means due to VI. Due to VI, I will make my 20 volts 0. Now tell me what is your output is. My output voltage is across the equivalent resistance of 10 kilo ohm in parallel with 5 kilo ohm. Right? So these two are in series. So output voltage is given by VI into 10 kilo ohm in parallel with 5 kilo ohm by 10 kilo ohm in parallel with 5 kilo ohm plus 2.5 kilo. What is V naught dash due to VI? This is the equivalent circuit. Make it first. it is 4 by 7 VI, okay, plus output due to the 20 volts. When the output is due to the 20 volts, you keep the 20 volts as it is and you make your input shorted, okay. So this is what is your V naught double dash, okay, your V naught double dash. 500 by 177, okay, 500 by 177. Okay, sir, tell me what is V naught when VI is equal to 50, because we were asked to find out the transfer characteristics only for varying the input from 0 to 50. So when VI is equal to 50, what is your output is? When VI is equal to 50, what is your output is? And VI is equal to 50, what is your output is? When VI is equal to 50, what is your output is? Any answer? 31.3. Okay, right. So now you tell me for what range of my input signal my output is found out to be some constant. Okay, for 0 to 3 volts, what is my output you found out to be? For 0 to 3 volts, what is the output you found out to be? 3 volts. Okay, for 0 to 3 volts input, you found your output to be 3 volts. And in between 3 to 9, okay, in between 3 to 9, what is your output is? Here you are asked to draw the transfer characteristics where you need to indicate the state of the diodes in each of the interval and as this, at the same time the slope, okay. The slope means you are always trying to get your output is equal to some y is equal to mx plus c form, okay, where x is your input, okay, y is your V naught. For example, you see here your output is equal to y is equal to mx, okay, x is your input, the slope is 4 by 7, okay, right. So in almost all the intervals you will be getting output in this particular form, which is like your y is equal to mx plus c, so that your slope is being given by 4 by 7 in this particular case. Similarly, for 3 to 9, what is your slope? For 3 to 9, what is your slope is? For 3 to 9, what is your slope is? For 3 to 9, the slope is half. In between 9 to 30, in between 9 to 30, what is the slope is given by?
2 by 3.
2 by 3. Okay, and from 30 to 50, I need to vary only up to 50. Exactly at 50, what is the value we got? 31.3. So exactly at 50, the value I got is, and what is the slope is? 4 by 7. Okay, the slope is 4 by 7. Right? Slope is 4 by 7, and this particular value is 31.3. This particular value at t is equal to vi is equal to 30, you can find out. Vi is equal to 9, you can find out. Vi is equal to 3, it is 3. Okay. So this is what is expected. Okay. You are supposed to draw the transfer characteristics where you need to indicate the slopes. Okay. Where you need to indicate the slopes. At the same time, status of the diodes. Okay. Write down what is the status of your diodes in this region. Write down what is the status of the diodes in this region. Write down what is the status of diodes in this region. Write down what is the status of diodes in this region. Okay. So that is with which we will be ending the problem. Okay. If you don't write your status of diodes for each of the regions, it is more or less incomplete. Okay. So don't forget to write the status of the diodes in each of the regions. Okay. Right. So is the problem is okay? We have considered a multi-level clipping circuit where you could see three diodes. And we have followed a very systematic process Yes or no? We have followed a very systematic process. We have started with vi is equal to 0. Thereby, we come to know that up to what value of my input I can vary so that my D3 is going to be either in the off state or in the on state. Then I have extended my range of my input signal. Then again, I have understood that how long my state of the diodes can hold good. Okay. Then I have proceeded until the maximum value and so on. Okay. Right. Is this fine? So if this is fine, you have to do it as an assignment and you need to submit it by today itself. The same problem, except that I'll be changing the numerals. Okay. The same structure, except that I'll be changing the numerals. You have to do it yourself and you have to complete it with the ending of the problem, that is writing the state of the diodes in each of the regions. Okay. Please do note down this question. Okay. Make it fast. All resistors are 10 kilo ohm, 10 volt source and 40 volt source. Right. So I'll give you one problem. Okay. So please try to do this. Draw the, okay, the question is like this. Draw the transfer characteristics. Draw the transfer characteristics. Transfer characteristics. Transfer characteristics using constant voltage drop model. Using constant voltage drop model. Okay, using constant voltage drop model. I hope you all are aware that what is a constant voltage drop model. If my diode is there, I'll be replacing an ideal diode followed by the forward biased voltage drop of the diode. Okay, ideal diode followed by forward biased voltage drop of the diode. Right, so when I replace my diode with forward biased voltage drop of the diode, okay, right, so this is your V gamma. So when I replace my diode with the forward biased voltage drop, is this fine? Is this okay? So how do we proceed? I have replaced my diodes with constant voltage drop model. I have replaced my diodes with constant voltage drop model. Now my equivalent circuit is looking like this. Okay. Now my equivalent circuit is looking like this. Okay. So let us consider an interval from minus infinity to Vi is less than minus V gamma. Okay. Please do understand, okay? Let us say V gamma is equal to 0.7. V gamma is equal to 0.7, right? Minus infinity to minus V gamma. What is minus V gamma means? So when your input is minus infinity to minus V gamma, when my Vi is less than minus V gamma, that is input less than minus 0.7, what are the values? Inputs less than minus 0.7, that means minus 0.8, minus 0.9. For this particular region, can you tell me what is the state of my diodes? Let us say this is D1 and this is D2. Which diodes are going to be on and which diodes are going to be off? From here to here, input is negative. Okay. From here to here, input is negative. As my N side of my diode is tied to the positive, if my input is negative, what do you say about the D1? Off.
Off.
Off. D1 is off. Okay, so I'll replace my D1 with open circuit. Okay, I'll replace my D1 with open circuit. Right, so what do you say about your D2? Is it going to be on or off? My P side is being tied to 0.7 and I'm saying that it is less than 0.7. That means it is minus 0.8, minus 0.9. That means either not that my N side is less than my P side. Yes, then my D2 is going to be in the on state. That means what is that? I can replace this with, I can replace this with a short circuit. Okay, I can replace this with a short circuit. So what is my output is given by? My output is given by, just apply KVL. Vi I'll be going in this direction. Okay, minus vi minus v gamma. Okay, I'll say that this is v gamma, right? Minus v gamma plus v naught is equal to 0. So what is my v naught is given by vi plus v gamma. Okay, my v naught is given by vi plus v gamma. In which range? In this particular range, v naught is given as vi plus v gamma. Okay, vi plus v gamma, right? Next interval that I can have is in between v gamma and minus v gamma and plus v gamma. Is my diode is going to be on or off? Is my diode is going to be on or off? My vi is less than v gamma, off. What do you say about this diode? Is it on or off? My vi is greater than minus v gamma. Okay, when my vi is greater than minus v gamma, what is
off.
About off? Both
off.
Are being off. When both are being off, what is your output is? When both are being off, what is your output is? This is off, and both are being off, what is your output is within this interval? Both are off. That means no current can flow through your R. So what
zero.
Is your V naught is? Zero. Okay? V naught is zero. Right? So now the interval is V gamma. Okay? V gamma is less than Vi is less than infinity. Okay? V gamma is less than Vi is less than infinity. So what is my equivalent circuit is going to be? My equivalent circuit is going to be, okay? What is my equivalent circuit is? Which diode is going to be on?
D1.
D1 is going to be on. Okay. So which one is going to be on? This is on. Okay. So this is off. Right. So when this is off. Right. So what is my output voltage is given by? My output voltage is given by minus Vi plus V gamma plus this is voltage, okay, plus V naught is equal to 0. So what is my V naught is given by? V naught is equal to Vi minus V gamma. Okay, V naught is equal to Vi minus V gamma. Is this okay? So we have considered the entire range of the input signal, that is from minus infinity to infinity. But we split into three intervals. One is minus infinity to minus V gamma, where your D2 is in the on state. Minus V gamma to V gamma, where your both of the diodes are in the off state. And your V gamma to infinity, where your D1 is said to be in the on state. Okay, right? So with the help of this information, we can easily plot the transfer characteristics. Okay, with the help of this information, we can easily plot the transfer characteristics. So in this interval, what is the output is given by? V naught is equal to Vi plus V gamma. In this interval, my output is given by 0. In this interval, my output is given by Vi minus V gamma. Okay, so can you plot the transfer characteristics now? Can you plot your transfer characteristics now? Yes, I can. Okay, so my input is here, my output is here. Okay, so let me plot like 0. So this is 0.7, let us say. Okay, this is 0.7. Okay, so now let us try to plot this transfer character. Okay, so let us take this interval. When I am in this interval, okay, that is in between minus infinity to minus 0.8. Okay. Minus 0.8. What is my output is given by? My output is given by. My output is given by Vi plus V gamma. What is V gamma? 0.7. Okay. What is that my Vi can be? Minus 0.8, minus 0.9, and so on and so forth. For example, when you substitute your Vi as 0.7, minus 0.7, what happens? As this is plus 0.7, this is going to be minus 0.7. What is your output is? 0. Okay, my output is going to be 0, right? So my output is 0. when my VI is minus 0.8, this is plus 0.7. Okay, this is nothing but VI plus 0.7. You substitute your minus 0.8, minus 0.8 plus 0.7. Okay, minus 0.1. Where I can locate my minus 0.1? My minus 0.1 is somewhere here. If this is 0.8, my minus 0.1 is somewhere here. When I substitute 0.9, minus 0.9, minus 0.9 plus 0.7, that is minus 0.2. So minus 0.2 is somewhere here. Okay. So my minus 0.9 is somewhere here. Okay. For minus 0.9, my output is 0.2. So 0.2. Okay. It is going to be 0.3. Okay. For minus 1, okay, minus 1 plus 0.7, so minus 0.3, so minus 0.3, so my eat something. Is this okay? Yes or no? At 0.7, it is 0, okay? So at 0.8, it is 0.1, 0.2, so it is going like, okay? At 0.7, it is 0. Is this okay? In between minus 0.7 to plus 0.7, what is my output is? 0. So my output is 0. Okay. So in between minus 0.7 and plus 0.7, my output is 0. Right. So for greater than 0.7 to infinity, my output is given by input minus V gamma. What is input minus V gamma? V gamma is 0.7. Okay. V gamma is 0.7. Where your input can be? Greater than 0.7. Let us say 0.8. 0.8 minus 0.7 is 0.1. My 0.1 is somewhere here. Okay. My 0.1 is somewhere here. This is 0.8. Okay. For 0.9. 0.9 minus 0.7. 0.2. So 0.2. Okay. For 1. 1 minus 0.7. 0.3. 0.3. Okay. For different values of my VI, greater than 0.7, when I substitute in my output equation, I can get my graph like this. Okay, so this is how my transfer characteristics are going to look like for the given circuit. Okay, this is how the transfer characteristics are going to look like for the given circuit. Okay, is this fine? Right? Okay.